So whether you're a fan of the cold or the milder weather, you're actually going to see both this week. We have meteorologist Robert Sir here with your Get Ready forecast. So up and down, huh?
Yeah, and it was that storm that brought us all that heavy rain and severe weather Friday and into Saturday, and then a little bit of snow Saturday night, that skiff of snow that we got. It became a nightmare for the Mid-Atlantic, which we'll get into here in a second. Right now, live look outside. Sunset just wrapping up in Springdale. Clear skies, light winds. That's why we're down to 37 degrees. Those winds south-southeast at 5 miles an hour. So nice and gentle out there. Across northwest Arkansas in general, we're mostly in the 30s. Drake Field already down to 34. But the inverse of that, it's in Centerton, 43 degrees. So not too bad. River Valley in the intersection of 540 and Kelly Highway there, not too bad. 38 degrees as well. Your winds out of the east northeast right now at 7 miles an hour. Elsewhere across the River Valley, mostly parked between 37 and 38 degrees. So warmer than we were yesterday. And you can thank a little bit more of a zonal flow today for aiding in that brief warm up. The wind's not coming more out of the northwest, more from west to east, and that will continue tomorrow, where it kind of flattens out even more, which will allow our temperatures to jump into the lower 50s. But it won't last, because by tomorrow we'll see a very strong cold front across the northern plains. More Arctic air is heading this way by the time we get to later in the week, which you'll see here in the 7-day forecast. Under the influence of this area of high pressure, it's keeping us quiet and dry. As it moves away, winds around it will increase out of the south, and that will also help our temperatures to warm up. This is the big storm system that brought all that snow to the Mid-Atlantic earlier today. I saw pictures of Interstate 95 between Richmond and Washington, D.C., just completely covered with snow. That's a rare snowstorm for those folks. Taking you through hour by hour tonight, mostly in the upper 20s, not a bad night, clear skies, very windy tomorrow, which will aid in helping us warm up. Weak cold front crosses early in the day on Wednesday, knocks our temperatures down a degree or two, but the second cold front is what will really cool us off. Lows tonight, we're mostly in the mid to upper 20s out there, and then tomorrow, as I said, most everybody should get into the lower 50s for your Tuesday. There's that front on Wednesday, so we go from 48 to 43. The stronger front rolls in here Wednesday and into Thursday, might have a little bit of snow with it. We're keeping our eye on that. And look at our temperatures falling throughout the day Thursday, throughout the 20s, and we'll bottom out Friday morning in the lower teens, struggling to get into the 30s on Friday, but then it's brief again, and we start to warm back up into the 50s as we get into the upcoming weekend. In the River Valley, about the same thing. You can see there lots of sunshine, and then we cool off on Thursday and start to warm up as we get into the weekend with the outside chance for a couple of showers. Now, if you joined us over the weekend, we were saying 55 for Prairie Creek. We got the 56. That is a congratulations to Rebecca Richardson of Lowell. She's going to get the Darby Bybee umbrella, one of the second ones of 2022. Tomorrow we'll take you to Cameron, Oklahoma, where we're forecasting a high of 57 degrees. Brandon.
All right, Robert. Lot to keep track of. Thanks for doing that. Well,